behind this controversial program defended it to CNN, saying it was groundbreaking. But we've learned Senator Reid was persuaded to push this program by a longtime friend who had donated to his campaigns, a man who says he believes in UFOs and aliens. Commander David Fravor still can't explain what he says he saw that day. November 2004, the Navy fighter pilot was on a training mission west of San Diego when he was ordered to check out something in the water not far away. On a clear day, over a smooth ocean, he saw the object, waves breaking over it, and says he saw something hovering above it.
It's randomly moving north, south, east, west, just random, you know, just stopping, going the other direction. Like you could do with a helicopter, but it's a little bit more abrupt. It looks like a 40-foot-long tic-tac with no wings.
Fravor says he and his four-man team tracked the object for several minutes until it just disappeared. Tonight, CNN has learned the Pentagon had a secretive program to research UFOs like the one Fravor spotted. The project was called the Advanced Aviation Threat Identification Program, run by an official named Luis Elizondo.
I think this is a national security imperative. We have clear things that we do not understand how they work, operating in areas that we can't control.
A defense official tells CNN the program cost at least $22 million over 5 years before it was shut down in 2012. According to the New York Times and Politico, which first reported this story, tens of millions of dollars for the project were pushed through by former Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid. Those publications say a lot of the money for the Pentagon UFO program went to a company called Bigelow Aerospace, run by a longtime friend of Reid's, Robert Bigelow, a big believer in UFOs. Public records show Bigelow contributed about $20,000 to Reid and his political action committee.
That campaign contributor got research contracts from this program. That just is a bad picture. It doesn't look good for anybody. It's hard to imagine that something that came about that way and profited somebody who pushed for the program was a good use of taxpayer money.
A Pentagon spokesman, in fact, told CNN the program was shuttered because there were, quote, other higher priority issues that merited funding.
It's definitely crazy to spend $22 million to research UFOs. Pilots are always going to see things that they can't identify, and we should probably look into them. But to identify them as UFOs, to target UFOs to research, that is not the priority we have as a national security matter right now.
But pilots like Fravor, who says he saw something, see merits in the program.
What if it is real, because I think it's real because I saw it, and what if there's more of these, and what if we do nothing?
Now, just a short time ago, Senator Reid responded to CNN, saying he's, quote, proud of this program and its groundbreaking studies. Speak for themselves, he says. Reid says it's silly and counterproductive to politicize the serious questions raised by the work of the UFO program. The head of that aerospace firm, Robert Bigelow, did not respond to CNN's multiple requests for comment by our deadline.
Well, Brian, there's also information that former Senator Reid tried to keep information about this entire program out of public use.
That's right, Wolf. The New York Times says Reid acknowledged to them that he and two other senators, Ted Stevens and Daniel Inouye, both deceased, did not want public debate on the Senate floor over this program. Reid told the Times that the funding for the project was so-called black money, meaning that was secret money for classified programs they just didn't want it talked about.
Brian Thomas reporting for us. Brian, thank you. Coming up, the breaking news. There are now multiple deaths as a